Now let's talk about the skills required for use of an AED, but the patient is a 17-year-old teenager. They're gonna fit in with our adult level protocol when we use an AED, but this is very common. In fact, we've heard about it in the news a lot, where you've got these kids, they're somewhere between 14, 18 years old, they're on the court, they're on the field, and they are healthy individuals seemingly, and then they go down in cardiac arrest. So this is kind of the scenario that we're setting up for you, and we wanna kind of show how easy it is to get them the help they need in a rapid form. So here we go, the scene is already safe, CPR has already been in progress, and whether we brought the AED in or someone else brought it in, the point is it's here and it's ready to use. So let's go ahead and begin. When we have the AED here, the very first thing we're gonna do is turn it on.
Remove clothing from person's chest.
So it tells us to remove the clothing. Many times they'll have a scissors right in the back.
Attach pads firmly to person's chest as shown.
Tells me to attach the pads and plug in the connector, so I'm going to work on that.
Check connector and pads.
If I open this up, I can see exactly the way these are supposed to go. One goes here, and one goes here, just like it shows right on the pads. Now, special note, if they're sweaty, dry them off. If there's any kind of gel, dry it off. If there's jewelry, it doesn't matter if they have piercings, but if they have a necklace and it's in between these two pads, we're gonna move that jewelry just to the side so it's not in the way of the electrical pathway. These are actually sticking quite well, so now I'm gonna go to the last step, which is plugging in the connector.
Analyzing rhythm. Everyone stand clear.
Make sure not to touch the patient, don't bump them.
Shock advised. Charging. Everyone stand clear.
Okay, we allow the AED to charge.
Everyone stand clear. Push the shock button.
Nobody's touching the patient, I discharge.
Shock delivered. Begin 5 cycles of CPR.
Now, it's important that we go straight into chest compressions, the same way we did CPR, that 2 to 2.4 inch depth, 100 to 120 compressions per minute. We go right over the cable, we go right over the AED pads. We don't remove them, we don't disconnect them, we just do our compressions right over them. We could follow the metronome, but it's not necessary. We know how to do these CPR compressions, but we're gonna do the normal CPR. So we're doing our 30 compressions. After the 30 compressions, just like before, we do the head tilt, chin lift, and we give 2 rescue breaths. Going right back into the chest compressions. 7, 8, 9, 10, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, followed by 2 more breaths. Followed by 30 more compressions.
Analyzing rhythm. Everyone stand clear.
When it interrupts, we stand clear and let it analyze for a rhythm.
No shock advised. Begin 5 cycles of CPR.
So whether it says a shock is advised, it recharges so that you can shock, or whether it says no shock advised, we're gonna follow its promptings and go right back into whatever it tells us to do. We are gonna continue to do this without taking anything off or turning anything off until EMS arrives, until the person revives and starts breathing normally, or somebody equally trained or higher comes and relieves us.